So before I get into the video proper, I wanted to kind of do kind of like a housekeeping as to why I'm making this video. And before G5 started and it was just character reveals, I felt like Sunny and Pip and Zip had my favorite character designs. The characters, also Izzy. And then when the movie came around, Pip, Sunny, and Zip became my favorite. Then once the Make Your Mark and Tell Your Tale era began, Pip, Sunny, and then Zip got knocked out because Misty is just, that's just me. That's just me coded. and then Pip is, listen, if you know me on this channel, if you're a pink character, and also if you fall in the line of singer category, yeah, you're just going to be my favorite based on that aesthetic alone. But with Sunny, it always felt weird, and I never really talked about Sunny. I only really limited myself to just Pip and Misty for the most part, and I don't know, for me personally, it just felt weird to be a Sunny fan. It always felt like you could only be a fan of movie Sunny and whatever the fandom concocted as a, I don't like G5, but here's my interpretation. And keep in mind, there's no issues in that. Trust me, I'm a Descendants fan. We pretty much did that on a regular basis, so I get that, so I take no issues in that. You do your fanon, go ahead. But I don't know, it just always felt weird to be a Sunny fan, and I kind of wanted to present my thoughts as a Sunny fan, showing how I view Sunny in the landscape of what G5 is doing. So the one thing about Sunny that I've noticed is that her favorite story from G4 is the Friendship is Magic 2-part premiere of season 1. And that makes sense. I can see why Sunny liked that story in particular, because once Twilight gets to Ponyville, she starts to make those connections, and then the two-parter, those connections become stronger, and they defeat Nightmare Moon in the end because of what each character brought to the friendship group and how important that meant to Sunny finally finding her clique, essentially. And I feel like for Sunny, that was very inspiring and something that she wanted in her life herself. Which is funny considering that that happened in the movie. And I see why that story in particular inspired Sunny. But the thing about Sunny is she's interested in G4 lore like her dad was. However, that really what, like the big lore and all of that stuff, that was not Sunny's takeaway from Generation 4. What I've noticed is whenever Sunny brings up G4 in Make Your Mark, outside of the big lore stuff that's like important to the context of in the now moment, which is that's something about Sunny when it comes down to G4 lore, if it comes at her doorstep, it'll be important for the context of that. But for the most part, Sunny is more about the Hurricane Fluttershy type of stuff than, say, A Canterlot Wedding Part 1 and Part 2. And that kind of circles back to Sunny's dad. Sunny isn't Argyle 2.0. Sunny's takeaway from G4 was far different from her dad's. And even then, we don't even know Argyle's takeaway of G4 100% outside of being the lore guy. And that's it. And Sunny just isn't the lore girl. She's just a girl who liked Generation 4, what it represented, but she more so liked the Friendship is Magic Part 1 and Part 2s, and a thing like Hurricane Fluttershy of what takeaway did Fluttershy get out of this week's episode? And when you watch things like Tell Your Tale and Make Your Mark, that fits Sunny pretty well. I'm going to be honest with you. I get why people misunderstand Sunny's cutie mark, simply because Twilight's cutie mark, it's supposed to be magic and stuff, and it's supposed, and you know, her other part of her name is Sparkle, and her cutie mark is supposed to represent the sparkle. But if we're being honest, it is kind of giving a star a bit. So I can see why people thought Sunny's cutie mark was supposed to be magic only because of Twilight. But yeah, no. Sunny's name is Sunny Star Scout, not Sunny Sparkle. So with that being said, her star in the Star Scout name, what the writers of the movie did was they pretty much took the star gimmick in her name, made it a shooting star, looked up the definition of a shooting star, and they based her whole character, personality, and what she represents, wrap that into one, and boom, you have My Little Pony, A New Generation movie that fits Sunny's cutie mark. The cutie mark was supposed to fit the movie than anything else. Anything afterwards, not so much. And I don't mean that in a mean way, disregarding the TV show staff. No, that's not what I'm doing. But Sunny was built for the movie, and after that, the other crew could take the wheel, you know? But Sunny's arc is supposed to represent new change and hope for a better tomorrow. And that's what Sunny does in the New Generation movie. So she represents that pretty well in the movie. TV show wise, in terms of how she got her cutie mark, I feel what I'm going to do is I'm going to play a clip of her getting her cutie mark, and I'm going to put the definition that I found about shooting stars. You'd be shocked how her cutie mark story matches up with the definition.
Back when I was a little filly, I didn't have many friends, but my dad always said, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade and sell it to raise money for the library. So I did. My lemonade was a hit. I sold almost every cup right away, but two ponies wanted the last one. They started arguing, but then I stepped in to help. They realized they were fighting for no reason. That's when my cutie mark appeared. My dad told me it's because I helped those ponies put aside their differences. He was so proud. That spring, I got to trot the stage in our cutie blossom bash. It's one of my favorite memories.
So, slight recap. We established that Sunny's takeaway from G4 is most of the history. She knows most of it, but if not all of it. But she doesn't really care about the MacGuffin and lore side of things. She cares more about the small-scale stuff. Twilight making friends in the pilot episode and how important she discovered her friends were. And to little things like Hurricane Fluttershy. What does this story mean for Fluttershy, and what was her takeaway out of that episode? We also realize that Sunny's cutie mark doesn't represent magic. It represents a shooting star, which represents hope and new beginnings for a better tomorrow. So, with that being said, Sunny was built to live in the G5 world building in terms of the recording of this video. not only is her bestie group also representing the other locations, but for the most part, Maritime Bay, small town, beach, city, very small, small town based, very, very small, small in scope, which fits Sunny pretty well because she's just a simple girl living in a very simple town. Then you have Zephyr Heights, which is just big city with a castle, but with Pegasi. Then you got Bridalwood, cottage core, but is the most magical out of the three locations. So, if anything, Bridalwood is the one with the most magic and interesting lore stuff. But for Zephyr Heights and Maritime Bay, they're just very simplistic things you see in the real world. And I feel like that fits Sunny pretty well. And also the world. G5, when it comes down to tell your tale, it's just about the ponies just vibing together. Every now and then, it's more so in the latter half of Tell Your Tale Season 1, and also the more recent Season 2 episode, we get holidays that are based on in-real-life holidays, but ponified. And I feel like me mentioning that Sunny comes from a very small town, and what her cutie mark represents, Sunny mostly just cares about what she can do in the now. What can she do with the ponies around her in either Maritime Bay, Zephyr Heights, or Bridalwood, but for the most part Maritime Bay, because it's become more of a Ponyville type melting pot area. What can she do to help herself and others around her? And what can she do with the magic to help herself, others, and to better the world around her? So here's the tea. G5 isn't really G4 in the sense of writing approach, and I'm also pretty sure the Bible of G5 as well. Here's the thing, with G4, Twilight was always built to be the main protagonist no matter what. Now, her bestie group and the 22 some odd episode season order, the other members of the main six can easily be a main character when they get an episode focused on them, and they can grow and change as well. But no matter what, Twilight's like the main it girl. G5 didn't do this. In fact, we have three main characters in Make Your Mark: Sunny, Zip, and Misty. These three have the most growth going for them, and they ended up being the main protagonists. I'm not going to talk about Misty because Misty was kind of doing her own thing, and to make a joke here, she was making her own mark. Also, Zip as well. Did you guys know that Rainbow Dash is like the most popular G4 character? Yeah, who would have thunk? With that being said, Zip does fill the Rainbow Dash archetype. And the crew of the TV show leaned into that. Removing Tell Your Tale, because that did come after the movie, remove that. Make Your Mark was our return after the movie. And guess who was the main character? okay, well, everyone was the main character, but the main character of the story was Zip. This is the moment where they introduce that she's going to become a detective, and also the fact that she's interested about the lore of both G4 and G5. Now, this is where we get into the Sunny aspect. Now, in the past bullet points, I've mentioned everything about Sunny. There's one thing I left out. Sunny is a very emotional character. And I feel like this is an aspect a lot of people miss out on when talking about Sunny. But for the most part, she is the emotional driven character. And we've seen that in the movie. And that pretty much progressed and hasn't really changed since the movie. That's been a core part of her, whether or not she's emotional for herself or others around her. And when it comes down to ignoring Zip about the crystals, for Sunny, she was worried that if the crystals were to break or whatever, she would essentially lose what she built for in the movie. The magic and her friends. But because she was ignoring Zip's feelings, she ended up becoming a bad friend in the long run. Sunny's arc in that Make Your Mark pilot was to learn to communicate properly about her emotions and also to listen to others and to just communicate properly. But she learned something very important. Whenever someone in the bestie group brings up a concern, she's going to listen going forward, but also mostly Zip when it comes down to the lore and everything else like that. And because of that, her and Zip's friendship became stronger because of that. After that moment, there's two characters she goes to: Hitch or Sunny, or both, or everyone in the bestie group. Now here's the tea, though. This doesn't mean that Sunny doesn't care about G4 or G5 lore. Do you guys remember in Tell Your Tale that Zip saw that hit because Sprout got deplatformed and fired from being Sheriff Number 2, Hitch was going through it and she offers up to help Hitch? Okay, her job entailed her being a detective after that. So Zip has a job. Her job is detective. You guys do realize that, like, Sunny, Zip, Pip, Izzy, and now Misty live in that Bright House? I showed that clip of Sunny getting her cutie mark earlier for a reason, not only to help the definition, but also Sunny having a lemonade stand was something that she wanted to do going forward after she got her cutie mark. This girl is a foodie. Like, she loves to bake and, like, make food and also drinks. Sunny's job is her little fruit stand cart thingy. That is her job. Homegirl has to pay the bills to keep the Bright House on. Izzy, her crafting job, that's her job. Pip, she has the salon. Misty's the only one who doesn't have a career right now, but that's justifiable. Homegirl's been through it. But, like, each pony has to pull their weight to keep that Bright House bills on. Like, Sunny's job is Smoothie King. We all joke about that, but, like, she has to pay the bills. And with that said, Zip paying the bills is literally detective. In both Make Your Mark and Tell Your Tale, Sunny will go, okay, I have time to either hang with the besties, or I can help Zip with G4 and G5 lore. Sunny cares about what's going on. Here's one of the biggest problems.
What do we do? Familiar.
We do nothing.
Huh? Really?
All we know is that Allura was trapped in Starlight Ridge. Did she do some mean things? Yes. Yes, she did. But maybe she'll be different here with us. Every pony deserves a second chance.
And if not, we'll be ready. I'm a princess of a different kind. Always trying to figure out why. When my cutie mark comes to life, I blast bravely across the sky.
I am all three pony kinds, wrapped up into one. My cutie mark comes to life with hope right as the sun.
I've talked about this before, but when Make Your Mark and Tell Your Tale were being made, and especially G5 in season one of both Make Your Mark and Tell Your Tale, they were made to appease to the brony fandom, but in the process, they didn't realize that those old complaints nowadays do not work. They in fact aged like milk. The fandom had no idea what its priorities were. They really didn't know what show they signed up for, quite literally, until this era happened. Before, it was like, oh, ew, gross, 22 some odd episodes? Well, hopefully, we don't get filler episodes, which, like, did you watch season one? but, like, that joke aside, afterwards, people realized, oh, damn, Generation 4 was, like, raw family television. Banger two-part season premieres, your 22-some-odd episodes of cute fun times, banger two-part season finales. And then somewhere in between, cute and fun holiday episodes. People are now realizing that television, and especially the old school ways of television, is very important. Sadly, Hasbro built the show to appease the fandom. Continuity, lore-driven, Make Your Mark, Tell Your Tale is your filler. Both of these shows, back in season one, you can tell it was chaos. I brought it up, and multiple fans have brought that up, that both Make Your Mark and Tell Your Tale, both of their priorities, didn't work out in the end. And one of the biggest problems is because ponies was not prepared for this at all. Ponies was so used to linear television, they were not prepared for the streaming service era, and they were not prepared for YouTube shorts. They were not prepared for both. Compared this to Strawberry Shortcake, Barry in the Big City, or even Unicorn Academy, both of these shows have their priorities straight right out of the get-go, and there haven't been any problems. G5 was not ready for it, and you can tell. Tell Your Tale, it's got its fair share of issues, but it's not on par to Make Your Mark. But I would say Tell Your Tale has managed to be the most, like, quality. Make Your Mark, I like a lot of Make Your Mark, trust, but they were not prepared to make a streaming service show. On the surface, it feels like they got things together. Animation can be a little iffy every now and then, but Make Your Mark very much rushed a lot of it. For example, the first time Sunny defeated Opaline, she pretty much goes, "Hey, if you mess with us again, I will come back and I will maybe beat your ass in your own home." Here's the tea, though. Sunny didn't know the Opaline lore. Like, she didn't know that she couldn't leave her castle and whatever area of Equestria had a bubble around it. speaking of that, yeah, it was never explained how Opaline was able to go to the Dragonlands, even though that area should have been off limits. Although you could argue her getting the Dragonfire pretty much helped that, but I don't know if that was before or after. Even Opaline has her fair share of problems. In the Battle for Opaline arc, there was a moment where each Bright House color of the rainbow represented each member of the main six. That was never explained. In G4, that would have been its own episode. You see how Make Your Mark and the formatting of Netflix screwed the show over? I'm poking holes at, like, the biggest, like, plot beat stuff, but it hurt the cast in the long run. With Make Your Mark, I just do not feel like we spent enough time with the cast. I will say this. They're lucky that Tell Your Tale exists simply for that. Again, Tell Your Tale has its own share of problems, but at least with Tell Your Tale and Make Your Mark, I get the narrative of what's going on. But sadly, when season one of both were going on, it was confusion and chaos. And I'm going to be honest, I see why Sunny got the most, this isn't the main character, Zip is. I get it. I fully get why. The thing is, Sunny is mama stock protagonist pony. And you know what? I'll say that. If your issues with Sunny are that she's just stock protagonist, I can get behind it. Hell, with Paw Patrol, I don't really care for Chase. And if the writers manage to make me care for Chase, great. But for the most part, Chase is just stock blue protagonist dog. The other cast of Paw Patrol I like a lot more than Chase. Doesn't mean I hate Chase. And we're going to remove a lot of the implications for the sake of my argument here, because we're not doing a Paw Patrol Chase video. But Chase just isn't for me, but I can get why other people like Chase. And with Sunny, I like her for being this simple, kind-hearted character. I can see why people don't care for that and gravitate more to a character like Zip. And luckily, the writers made the smart decision to make Zip the second protagonist. That was a bright idea by the writers. But sadly, Sunny was just kind of stuck, in a sense. In fact, the Opaline dragon catching Sparky, that was put on a pause. Tell Your Tale had to essentially do that until we were back with Make Your Mark again, and then boom, the Sparky capture thing is done. People complain about Opaline for the same reasons they complain about Sunny, but Opaline has it a lot more worse, and also Sunny doesn't have war crimes on her Wikipedia page. But when it comes down to it, Sunny didn't really step up as a character till around the time the moment they caught Sparky. After that moment, Sunny became a more active protagonist. She was working with Zip in Make Your Mark. And then by the end, sadly, she kind of realized what type of character she is. Like, they literally rushed her leadership role. They rushed her realizing that she represents hope. But I would be, if I'm being honest with you, the hope one I could actually get behind, because the show planted a lot of good seeds, and even with the movie as well. So that one I could give a little bit more leeway to. But the leadership one, that they definitely rushed to the finish line with that one. So that was very messy. And heck, it's not even just Sunny who got the worst end of the rushing stick. in the, I think the second part of the Opaline arc was when every character realized what element they represent, except for, like, I would say, like, Zip is the weirdest one, though. But, like, yeah, and then in, like, the winter theme episode thingy, I forgot what it, Secrets of Starlight, everyone was just shouting out what thing they represent in the bestie group, what element of friendship they represent, and it was, like, really weird, but, like, watching both more recently, I'm like, yeah, I get what the writers were doing, but they, oof, oh boy, they rushed to the finish line with that one. And, yeah, season one of both eras were just messy, and in the long run, it hurt Sunny as a main character, but when doing this deep dive and realizing why I like Sunny as a character and kind of defending her as a character, I realize there were bright spots. It's just that G5 was a very messy era, but I'm happy that I like Sunny as a main character. And honestly, I'm glad that, at least for me personally, I get the goals of what G5 is supposed to do. It, for the most part, I feel like the simple aspect of Sunny's character represents G5 as a whole. I think the continuity and all of that stuff really put a damper on G5, if anything else. Which, keep in mind, I don't think they were prepared for the David Zasloff WB Discovery, you have to give us money whenever you want to do anything G4 related. I don't think that they were prepared for that. But when it comes down to things like Tell Your Tale and things like that, G5's goal is to be fun, be wholesome, although there, I've talked about it before, there are a lot of not great implications about a, about like the movie and Opaline, so, you know, they got to work on that, but, you know, for the most part, fun, wholesome, fun times with ponies and trying to teach good lessons to kids. G5 stumbled a little bit in that department as well, but their heart's in the right place, and I get what they're trying to do. And if that's not for you, I get the vibe.